When one hears about the Protestant Reformation, one usually thinks of a man nailing a sheet of paper to the door of a church, when in reality it was much bigger than that. The Protestant Reformation was one of the largest schisms of the church, causing many different churches to form and many reformers to step up. Battles and military conflicts could have occurred from this event, but very few did. The churches compromised by agreeing to exist as different forms of Christianity.
The 11th century was near the end of a period in Europe known as the Dark Ages. The Dark Ages earned their name as people only lived to about 30. Few were literate, and the prevalent system of government was feudalism. Under feudalism, lords controlled manors where workers, known as serfs, farmed for their lord. The serfs made up the majority of the population, so nearly everyone was low class. During the Dark Ages, there were also no advancements in art or science, and people rarely left their villages, leading to a lack of exploration. There was also only one church, the Roman Catholic Church, which at one time was a corrupt Christian church that cared only about making money through indulgences, which were payments that supposedly relieved people of their sins.
The First Crusade was called against the Turks in the 11th century CE by the Roman Catholic Church leader Pope Urban II. These were called in order to rid the Holy Land of Jerusalem of the Turks and to create an outpost of the Catholic Church in the Middle East. Most participants thought it would be a way to repay for their sins and gain entrance to heaven. From a modern point of view, marching an army 2,000 miles to lay siege to a city already prepared for war would seem insane. But the kings of Europe were very powerful and felt that their armies were strong enough to be up to the task. The Muslims, however, had expanded their territory to include most of Asia Minor and had much of the population on their side. In the year 1095, Pope Urban made a speech in Rome encouraging knights to attack the Muslims in the Holy Land. After the speech, four bands of crusaders moved out to attack Jerusalem in unison. The crusaders' first attack was in Antioch, which was captured until the crusaders were pushed out by the Muslims. They then attacked Jerusalem, where they captured the city and massacred most of the citizens. The next two crusades were a military disaster. The crusader states in the Holy Land weakened, the Muslim general Saladin gained power, and the tension increased between Christians and Muslims. However, after the third crusade, the crusaders organized a 3-year truce with Saladin, allowing them time to prepare for yet another crusade. In the fourth crusade, the crusaders sacked the city of Constantinople and created the Latin Empire of Constantinople, which lasted for almost 60 years. All crusades after the fourth had little or no success, spelling the end of the crusades in 1291. The crusades were important because they caused trade and exploration in Europe to start again, ultimately leading to an age of artistic and scientific innovation called the Renaissance.
A primary result of this Renaissance was the invention of the printing press in 1439 by Johann Gutenberg. The printing press was a revolutionary invention because, for the first time after the Dark Ages, the common people could read books, and literacy became more widespread. This newfound literacy caused people to be able to read and interpret the Bible for themselves, and they discovered that many practices of the Catholic Church were against the teachings of Jesus. For example, the Catholics taught that paying the church was a good way to repent for your sins, while the Bible said that you had to have a personal relationship with Jesus. This caused dissent against the Catholic Church, with one man in particular leading the charge against the establishment, Martin Luther. This led to a new era for the Catholic Church known as the Protestant Reformation, which eventually led to violence and conflict. Families were even pitted against each other because of their different views, and each side believed that the other side was doing the devil's work. Art also started to be placed under extreme scrutiny because the Catholic Church wanted art to only portray very specific things.
To start the Protestant Reformation, Martin Luther nailed a copy of the 95 Theses to the wall of the Wittenberg Church in Germany. The 95 Theses was a list of propositions that stated that the Pope doesn't have the right to forgive sins through the sale of indulgences. The 95 Theses also stated that you didn't have to do favors in order to have faith. The Pope was upset at what Martin Luther had put on the door, and he ordered Luther to appear before the Cardinal Cajetan. Cajetan demanded Luther to retract all that he had said, but Luther refused because the only way he would obey the order would be if the Bible proved that he was wrong.
There were many calls for reform, but one of the loudest arguments was for the church to stop selling the aforementioned indulgences. This position was backed by the Bible, which stated that the only way to get to heaven was through a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. Most early reformers read the Bible and pointed out to the clergy that the sermons didn't quite match up to the Bible's texts, and attacked the corruption inside the clergy. Martin Luther really led the charge against the church. The difference between the early reformers and Martin Luther is that Luther was the first to complain about the hypocrisy in the church's system. Another reformer, Calvin, joined Luther as a second in command and published the Institutes of the Christian Religion, which solidified his breakaway from the Catholic Church. As time progressed, the Institutes of the Christian Religion became the most important doctrine of Protestant beliefs. Calvin was also very well respected within the Swiss city of Geneva, where he lived. He was often asked to advise the city on civic and religious matters. Calvin's teachings later became the main basis for certain Christian sub-religions, such as Puritanism and Calvinism.
The church's initial reaction to Martin Luther was rather passive, and they ignored him for quite a while. However, due to increased literacy and abundance of knowledge among the people, Luther's ideas eventually started to spread quicker than wildfire. After many people started to agree with Luther, the Catholic Church decided the only way to stop him would be to ask him to disregard his ideas at the Diet of Worms or be excommunicated. Luther would not give up on his ideas, and ended up being fully excommunicated from the Catholic Church. The church also set up a council just to deal with him, called the Council of Trent. The council met to decide the church's official standpoints on the issues brought forth by Martin Luther. The church decided it would still teach that you had to perform good deeds to make it into heaven, and that they would affirm the existence of purgatory, a place where people pay for their sins. This was against what Martin Luther thought, because he taught that all you needed to get to heaven was a personal relationship with Jesus. However, the church did not specifically say that Martin Luther could not protest anymore, so his hope of creating a non-corrupt church lived on. Throughout the 16th century, the Reformation lived on and gradually spread throughout Europe due to the work of the reformers. Luther and Calvin were supported by Ulrich Zwingli, a predominant Swiss reformer, and John Knox, an important Scottish reformer. England even started to accept some of these new ideas with the Toleration Act of 1689, which allowed certain forms of those ideas to be practiced. This was a big deal because previously, if one was not affiliated with the state's official church, one could be highly persecuted or even jailed.
The first usage of the term Protestantism was in 1529 at a religious assembly known as the Second Diet of Spires. During the 16th century, the term Protestant became used to describe Reformation traditions, Lutheran and Reformed. These two traditions shared the same main beliefs, including accepting the Bible as the supreme authority, believing in salvation by faith alone, and the early Christian statements of belief. England was a thriving place for Protestantism, even though only some forms were permitted under the Toleration Act of 1689, and it thrived there throughout the 17th century. However, in England, the term Protestant was often used to separate Anglicans, the dominant branch of English Protestants, from unorthodox religions such as Baptists. The first threat to Protestantism was the Enlightenment, a scientific revolution late in the 18th century, where people questioned the need for Christian teachings, ranging from the Bible to the birth of Jesus. At this point, there were two kinds of Protestants: liberals, who thought religion should be based on feeling, and that traditional Christianity was wrong, and conservatives, who agreed with older traditions. Liberal Protestantism continued to become more popular until the 19th century, when Darwin proposed evolution, which nearly all branches of Christianity thought was wrong. Later, World War I made people reject the optimism for human nature that liberals believed in, which brought more and more people to the conservative side, especially in the US. By the 20th century, Protestantism stopped being split across the liberal and conservative line, but it was still split into different branches.
There are many branches of Protestantism, ranging from Baptism to Presbyterianism. These churches are very diverse, even though they all come from the same basic ideas. One of the branches of the Protestant Church is the Episcopal Church. The Episcopal Church believes in the actual presence of Jesus Christ in the world. Another branch is the Presbyterian Church, which is based upon the teachings of John Calvin and bases its leadership in churchgoers and ministers. The final main church is the Lutheran Church. The Lutheran Church is based heavily in the medieval church but preaches a personal relationship with God. Some other churches are the Anglican, the Methodist, and the Evangelical churches.
The Protestant Reformation proved to be one of the most important schisms in the history of the Catholic Church. While it caused a great deal of conflict between churches and reformers, in the end, the churches were able to reach a compromise by splitting into multiple different churches and branches, laying the groundwork for the various Protestant churches we have today.